AUSA is the biggest show in North America for the military and the armored vehicle sector. We are supporting the US Army as well as its operations overseas, and we are bringing the Iag Sentinel here today to showcase its capabilities. So the vehicle right behind me is your basic, it's based off of a Ford F-550 Super Duty chassis, and it is sitting on a 6.7 liter engine. So basically it's a truck fully armored to a level B6 plus B7, which we actually are showcasing. So this vehicle here is fully armored, 360 degree protection for you, and this can basically stop your 50 caliber round. Now, we have a lot of interest that has peaked from obviously the US, you know, the government, the army and the forces overseas, as well as a lot of international delegations that have been present at AUSA this year. So this vehicle basically serves as a multi-purpose solution for many different agencies and departments in any government. So for the US, for example, this is a very popular solution to the existing militarized vehicles that we have in terms of its size, maneuverability, and obviously the chassis, which being Ford. Now, we are offering this variation to law enforcement agencies, SWAT teams around the country, border patrol, border security, as well as special branches within the government and the army who are looking for tactical response and rapid response units in the field. So this version behind me can, as I said, seats up to 10 people, 10 personnel, and mainly can be used for SWAT scenarios. So this vehicle that we have right now is actually coming back from a live test scenario that was used by 28 SWAT teams throughout the country, as well as 8 international special forces team that participated in this live training in California. So it has been proven, it has been quite popular, and we've been receiving some fantastic feedback on this vehicle. And I can only tell you this, that we are hoping that come 2015, you will be seeing different variations of the Iag Sentinel, both locally in the United States, as well as in the international market, more so piquing interest from Middle East and Africa at this point.